And now we are going to start the questions we can expect from the first unit. Now we are going to start with the chapter Living World. Okay. So as I told you, in the Living World, we have seen something about the taxonomy and what are all the taxonomic aids. Okay. How they classified the particular the entire living world and what are all the characters we have to consider for the living as a living world. Over here, this is the first question. The basic unit or smallest taxon or taxonomical classification. Okay. So here they are talking about the smallest or basic unit of the particular taxonomy. Okay. And we have seen the some other the levels of the classification. There are some other levels of the taxonomical hierarchy. We have seen something about the taxonomical hierarchy. Okay. So over there we have seen something about whatever may be the animal or whatever may be the living being, they are having two different words, the binomial nomenclature. Okay, one word, the first word represents the genus and the second word represents the species. Okay, so genus, species, and the genus are grouped into something. Okay, and the in that order we have seen something about the order or the hierarchical nature of the particular taxonomy, and based on that you have to answer the particular type of question and see the next question. Okay, both are almost the same question. Sequence of the taxonomic categories. Okay, so over here as I told you, they are giving the sequence of the taxonomical categories. That is, you have to identify the correct hierarchical nature of the particular taxonomical classification. Okay, see the choices over here: class, phylum, tribe, order, family, genus, species. This is one of the sequence they have given us the choice for you. But over here we all know the basic unit over here is species. Okay, and the next level, that is the common species or almost similar species, are grouped into genus, and the similar genus are being grouped into tribe, and the tribes are grouped into family, and the families are grouped into order, then class, then division. Okay, so this is the correct order of sequence of the particular taxonomical hierarchy, and the answer for the second question is C. The answer for the first question is species, because the species is the basic unit or the smallest taxon group of the taxonomical hierarchy or the classification. And see the third question. The term phylum was given by, this is one of the direct question, you have to be memorize the particular term. The Cuvier is the scientist who has given the name phylum for the particular category. And which one of the following animals, see the next question, which one of the following animal is correctly matched with its taxonomical category? Okay, so this is what you have to understand. Here they are talking about the taxonomical category. For example, over here they are giving the animal name tiger. Okay, they are giving the tigris, and they are giving the hint as species. How you have to understand this? Tiger is animal, their species name is tigris. This is how you have to understand the particular choice. And see the next choice, cuttlefish. Okay, their class is mollusca. Human, their family is primata. Housefly, their order is musca. Okay, see one by one. Housefly order is musca is not a correct choice. Okay, musca is a genus, leave that. This is not a correct answer. Primata is a order, not a family, you can leave that. Mollusca is a phylum, not a class, so this is not the correct choice. And Panthera tigris, that is what the name of the tiger. Panthera tigris. Panthera is a genus, tigris is a species. Okay, the tigris is a species name of the animal tiger, so this is the correct choice. Okay, this is how you have to understand the question and answer the type of questions over here. Now we are going to see the next set of questions from the same chapter Living World, and see the next set of questions over here. The common characteristics between the tomato and the potato will be at the level of there. Okay, here they are talking about the taxonomical level of two things. Okay, one is potato and another one is tomato. Okay, and they are giving the choices: family level, order level, division level, or genus level. Okay, so the point you have to remember over here, both the potato and the tomato belongs to the same family, Solanaceae. We are going to see the details of those family while we are discussing the morphology and anatomy. the point you have to remember over here, both are belongs to the same family. That means the answer for the first question is they are belongs to their at the family level. Okay, so they are at the family level, they are having or they are sharing the common characters. This is what you have to understand from the first question. And see the next question. The ICBN stands for, okay, here you have to expand the abbreviation ICBN and see the choices. International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, International Congress of Biological Names, Indian Codes for or Indian Code of Botanical Nomenclature or Indian Congress for Biological Names. Okay, so you have to find out the I stands for Indian or International. Just remember, I stands for International in ICBN. So you can easily eliminate the Indian choices. And now you have to find out which one is correct from the A and B, botanical nomenclature or biological names. Okay, ICBN stands for the particular botanical nomenclature. Okay, so this is the forum opened in the Linnaeus period. Okay, yes, started off with the naming of the plants with the help of the particular forum. Okay, so the ICBN stands for International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. See the next question. The most important function of the botanical garden is that. Okay, so here this is talking about the garden, botanical garden. What may be the most important function? Okay, and see the choices. They provide a beautiful area for recreation. One can observe the tropical plants there. They provide a natural habitat for wildlife. They allow excessive conservation of germplasm. Okay. So all the choices A, B and D applicable for the first question, applicable for the particular question. These are all the functions of the botanical garden. They are going to provide the natural habitat. They can, one person can observe the tropical plants over there. Okay, they are going to provide a beautiful area for recreation. But the question is talking about the most important function. Okay. The most important function among the choices given for you, the excessive conservation. Excessive conservation refers to over here the off-site conservation. Off-site conservation of the germs. Okay, they are going to maintain their seeds or germs in a controlled environment, as in the nature. Okay, so that they are going to maintain their living environment in a particular area. Okay, that is why this is the correct choice for the first question. This question, they allow excessive conservation of germplasm. They are going to maintain the germs or seeds of the particular plant in the particular botanical garden. And see the final question. The book Genera Plantarum was written by, and see the choices. This is a very direct question. The correct choice over here is Bentham and Hooker, who have written the particular type of book, the genera and plantarum. This is talking about the taxonomy or classification of some thousands of species. Okay, and this is how you have to understand and answer the questions from the first chapter, the living world. Now we are going to continue with the questions from the biological classifications. And now we are going to see the questions from the biological classification. Just remember, remaining all the things, all the questions we are going to see from the biological classification. We have seen all the biological classification, the taxonomy, from the taxonomy, all the five kingdom classification, all the kingdoms and the characters belongs to each and every kingdom, the classes, families, orders, phylums. Okay, so from this question we are going to see the entire unit as a single chapter. Okay, as I told you, all belongs to the biological classification. And see the first question. The classification given by the Bentham and Hooker is a type of artificial classification, natural classification, phylogenetic classification and numerical classification. Okay, so what are all the terms refers to over here? Artificial, natural, phylogenetic and numerical. So as I told you in the introduction classes, artificial classification was being done by Linnaeus and Aristotle. They have taken only the very superficial natures or characters of a particular living being or plant for the classification. Okay, and those kind of classification belongs to artificial taxonomy or artificial classification. But Bentham and Hooker, they have taken more characters to analyze or to classify or to identify the particular plant species or particular living being. Okay, they have taken more natural characters of the particular animal, and those kind of classification belongs to natural classification. So the answer for the first question is classification given by the Bendham and Hooker is a natural classification. Phylogenetic refers to the including the phylogenetic characters of the particular species. The numerical refers to, well, you are going to give the numbers for each and every characters you are going to analyze or identify the particular living being. Okay, numerical, giving the numbers for the classification. Okay, so the type they have taken, the Bendham and Hooker taken, is a natural type of classification. See the next question. The main difference between the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Okay, so gram positive and gram negative, the term refers to the gram. Gram was a scientist who has divided the entire bacterial world into two major areas or two major divisions, that is positive and negative. The question is talking about what is the major thing, or what, on what basis they are gonna classify the bacteria into two characters or two divisions, on basis of cell wall or basis of cell membrane, cytoplasm or flagellum. Okay, so just recall the gram staining. Gram staining is by using some different combination of stains, primary stain, secondary stain, mordant, and the decolorizer. We are going to give the colors to the external or morphological features of bacteria, and gram positive will appear as the purple color or violet color. The gram negative will be in a pink color or red color. Okay, so the point you have to remember over here, the external features, they are going to take up the particular color, and you have to identify which external feature they are going to take up the color. Cytoplasm, they are not going to take up the color, they are colorless substance or matrix. Flagella, they are not going to be stained by the gram staining. For the flagella, you have to perform the different type of staining, that is called flagella staining. So you have to choose in between the cell wall and the cell membrane. Okay, so originally the gram, who was the discoverer of the particular gram staining, he did the staining with the help of the characters of the cell wall. Okay, so the gram positive, they are having the thicker cell wall and less characters compared to the gram negative. Okay, in case of gram negative bacteria, they are having thin cell walls or thin layers of peptidoglycan, and they are having some other substances like lipopolysaccharides, acetic acids are also present in the gram negative cell walls. Okay, so the answer choice over here based on a cell wall, or the main difference between the gram positive and the gram negative, or the cell wall nature. And see the next question. The malignant tertian malarial parasite belongs to, okay, so here the classification of the malarial parasites. All the malarial major parasites are given for you: Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium malaria. You may attempt to choose the malaria as the choice for the malignant. Malignant is a persistent or most harmful, is called malignant. Okay, the opposite term for the malignant is benign. So we have come across these terms: malignant tumor, benign tumor. Benign tumor is curable, malignant tumor is somewhat tough to cure. The point you have to remember over here, the question is talking about the malignant tertian malarial parasite. Malignant, while you are seeing the term malignant, you may attempt to choose the malarial parasite, malaria, but this is not the correct answer. Plasmodium malaria will not cause the malignant tumor, they will cause the quaternary tumor. Okay, that is curable. And vivax and ovale are less tumor, less parasitic nature. Okay, this one is the most dangerous form of the malarial parasite, Plasmodium falciparum. They are the eminent killers of the particular parasitic group. And see the next question. Amebiasis is prevented by, okay, so what you have to do to prevent the amebiasis? And see the choices. You have to eat balanced food, you have to drink, you have to eat plenty of fruit, you have to drink boiled water, and you have to use mosquito net. Okay, and you should know something about the amebiasis. Amebiasis is caused by the end amoeba or amoeba. Okay, it's a kind of a protozoa. And no use of the using of mosquito net, and see the remaining choices. Amoeba is living in water environment. Okay, so there is no use of the eating plenty of fruit or eating balanced food, and you have to drink boiled water to prevent the amoebiasis. Okay, and see the next choice. See, genetic material in influenza virus. Influenza virus. Okay, it's a kind of virus. What may be the genetic material of the particular influenza virus? DNA, double helical DNA, RNA, single helix of DNA, and none of this. Okay, that must be some genetic material, either DNA or RNA. So you can easily eliminate the none of this, and you have to choose between the three: double helical DNA or single helical DNA or RNA. Influenza is a RNA bearing virus, so the answer choice over here is RNA. Okay, this is how you have to understand and you have to answer the question. Now we are going to see the next set of questions over here. And see the next question over here. What are the sex organs provided in some bacteria? Okay, we all know bacteria are belongs to prokaryotes, and prokaryotes are unicellular organisms. Okay, so here the question is talking about the sex organs of a prokaryote, a bacteria. And see the choices: sex pili, plasmid, circular DNA, and gametes. Just remember one thing: prokaryotes are bacteria. They are not going to provide, or they are not going to produce the gametes. Gametes are belongs to the evolved animals. Okay, so just evolved animals and plants. So forget about the gametes and see the remaining choices: circular DNA, plasmid, and sex pili. Circular DNA is a genetic material. Okay, that is going to be exchanged in between the bacteria, and they are not a organ or sexual apparatus for the particular bacteria. So you can easily eliminate that. Plasmid is also a kind of DNA. They are extracellular, extra chromosomal DNA of a bacteria, and the choice over here is sex pili. Okay, so in some bacteria, they are having small appendages, small flagella like structures present on the surface. Okay, with that structure is called pilus or pili. With that pilus, they are going to attach with each other. They are going to form a canal. And through that canal is called the conjugation canal. Through that canal, they are going to exchange the genetic material from donor to the recipient. Those who going to donate the particular DNA material is called donor, and those who receive the particular DNA is called receiver or the recipient. Over here, that kind of exchange, that mode of replication, that mode of exchange is called conjugation. And the answer over here is sex pili is a sex organ of the bacteria. See the next question: the DNA of E. coli. Okay, and see the choices: double stranded linear, double stranded circular, single stranded linear, and single stranded circular. Okay, so whenever we are talking about DNA, it is always double stranded. Okay, there are exceptions. In viruses, you can observe the single stranded DNA. Apart from the viruses, all the living cells in the world, they are having double stranded forms of DNA. So you can easily eliminate the single stranded circular and DNA, linear and circular. Over here, see the remaining two choices: double stranded circular or double stranded linear. Just remember one thing: in case of the prokaryotes, in case of bacteria, okay, so the DNA is in the form of CCC DNA. That means covalently closed circular DNA. Covalently closed circular DNA. That means the answer choice over here is double stranded circular DNA. You can observe the double stranded linear DNA only in the eukaryotic cell, such as the human body. Okay, in the human being, the DNA is in the form of linear form, and the linear DNA is in the form of chromosome along with the proteins, histones. Okay, so the answer over here is double stranded circular. See the next question: some bacteria are able to grow in streptomycin containing medium due to. Okay, so here is the question is talking about the ability of an bacteria growing in the medium containing the antibiotic streptomycin. Okay, so normally antibiotic will inhibit the bacteria, but some bacteria, they have the ability to grow in the streptomycin. What is the reason behind the particular ability? See the choices: natural selection, induced mutation, reproductive isolation, and genetic drift. Okay, so this is a direct question. The natural selection means by means of antibiotic selection, some bacteria, they are adapted to the particular environment, they are gonna survive and grow in the particular environment. And see the next question, the viruses. This question is talking about the viruses which infects the bacteria. Okay, so viruses that infect bacteria multiply and cause their lysis. And as I told you, this is talking about the bacteriophages. What are bacteriophages? That viruses, they are going to infect the bacteria, are called bacteriophages. And see the choices, lysozymes, lipolytic, lytic and lysogenic. Okay, and the point you have to remember over here, this question is talking about the viruses which gonna lyse the bacteria. Lysozymes are enzymes which are present within the eukaryotic cells. Just forget about the choice, this is not the correct choice. Lipolytic, this is the process called lysis of the lipids, so this is not the correct answer. And see the remaining choices, lytic and lysogenic, both are the lifestyle forms of viruses, belongs to the bacteriophages. But lysogenic refers to, they are going to infect the bacteria, but they will not kill the particular bacteria. They will live along with the particular bacteria, they will travel with the bacteria throughout their lifetime, that is called lysogenic. But the question is talking about the lysis. Okay, so the correct choice over here is lytic, is the correct choice for the particular question. And see the next question over here, which one of the following statements about the mycoplasma is wrong? Okay, just recall about the mycoplasma. Mycoplasmas are the smallest living entity in the world. As I told you, just forget about the viruses, we cannot consider that as a living entity because they are acellular particles. Apart from viruses, in case of bacteria, mycoplasma are the smallest living things because they lack cell wall. Okay, this is the point you have to remember. And see the choices, they are pleomorphic. Okay, they are also called PPLO, they are sensitive penicillin, they cause diseases in plants. Okay, and you have to find out the correct choice over here. They are pleomorphic. Pleomorphic means they are available in various shapes or irregular shapes. As I told you, they are lacking the cell wall. When there is no cell wall, they are in the pleomorphic. This is also the same choice. PPLO refers to pleuro. Okay, pleuro are pneumonia like organisms. Okay, so PPLO refers to the same pleomorphic nature. Okay, the question is talking about the wrong statement. Okay, so both are correct according to the mycoplasma's nature, so you can easily eliminate that. Okay, and they cause diseases in plants. This is also correct. Mycoplasma, they are gonna cause the diseases, but this is talking, question is talking about, are asking about the wrong statement. This is the wrong statement about the mycoplasma. They are sensitive to penicillin. Actually, they are resistant to penicillin because penicillin actually gonna act on the synthesis of cell wall. Okay, mycoplasmas are lacking the cell wall, so there will be no action of penicillin on the mycoplasma. So they are sensitive penicillin is a wrong statement according to the choices. And now we are going to continue the next set of questions. And see the next question now. Pick up the wrong statement. Okay, so over here there are some statements given for you, and you have to pick up the wrong statement among the choices. See the first one, first statement, some fungi are edible. Nuclear membrane is present in Monera. Cell wall is absent in Animalia. Protists have heterotrophic or photosynthetic mode of nutrition. Okay, and we'll see one by one. Some fungi are edible. This statement is actually correct statement. Okay, so mushrooms are edible, they are belongs to the fungi. So this statement is correct. The question is asking about the wrong statement, so you can easily eliminate that one. Cell wall is absent in Animalia. Animalia belongs to, all animals belongs to Animalia. They are lacking the structure called cell wall. That is the major difference from the other eukaryotic cells, the plant cells. Okay, plant cells, they are having the cell wall. Animalia, they are not having the cell wall. Okay, so the cell wall is absent is the correct statement, so you have to eliminate the choice. Protists are having the nutrition, various mode of nutrition, heterotrophic and photosynthetic, and that's also actually correct statement, so you can easily eliminate that one. And see the statement, Nuclear membrane is present in Monera. Monera belongs to the, all prokaryotes are the bacteria belongs to the Monera. Okay. So they are not having the nuclear membrane. They won't have the membrane bound structures. They won't have the nucleus. They won't have the nuclear membrane. So the wrong statement over here is the nuclear membrane is present in the Monera is the wrong statement. See the next question. Single celled eukaryotes are included in. Okay. So this question is talking about the classification, how we are going to include the particular single celled eukaryotic cells. Okay. And there are choices, protista, fungi, archaea and Monera. As I told you, Monera belongs to prokaryotes. In the Monera, archaea is a kind of class belongs to the Monera, and you have to choose between fungi and protista. Fungi, they have the multicellular structures also, as I told you, mushrooms. Okay, so you can easily eliminate the fungi. Protista, single celled eukaryotes are being grouped into the kingdom called protista. And see the next question. The virus envelopes is known as, okay, this question is talking about the virus covering. Okay, capsid, virion, nucleoprotein and core. Okay, and nucleoprotein, this is talking about the complete virus particle. That is, as I told you, any virus which contains type of genetic material, it may be DNA or it may be RNA, and it is being covered by a protein coat. Okay, DNA or RNA, along with, they are calling as nucleoprotein. Any virus particle is called as nucleoprotein. This question is talking about only the envelope of the virus, so you can easily eliminate the term nucleoprotein. That particle is called, nucleoprotein particle is called virion, so you can easily eliminate that term also. And you have to choose between the core and the capsid. Okay, the envelope is made up of the proteins called capsomeres, and the group of capsomeres are all called capsid. So the choice over here is capsid. Core refers to the internal portion of the particular virus. Okay, so the capsid is the correct choice for the particular question. And see the next question. In eubacteria, a cellular component that resembles the eukaryotes. Okay, so don't confuse the terms eukaryote and eubacteria. Eukaryotes belongs to all the cells, they are having the organelles. Okay, so what are the organelles? Any membrane bound structures, nucleus, Golgi apparatus, endoplasm, reticulum, mitochondria, chloroplast, all are the membrane bound structures. These membrane bound structures only present in the eukaryotic cells. Eubacteria refers to the true bacteria. They are belongs to the entirely different kingdom, that is Monera. There won't be any membrane bound structures in the particular bacteria. And this question is talking about a particular cellular component that resembles or common or identical or similar in between the eubacteria and eukaryotic structures. And see the choices: plasma membrane, cell wall, nucleus and ribosomes. And you may tend to choose for the ribosomes because both the bacteria and the eukaryotic cells, they are having the structures ribosomes. But there are different structures. In case of eubacteria, the ribosomes are 70S ribosomes. In case of eukaryotes, they are having 80S ribosomes. Okay. So, you can easily eliminate the ribosomes. Nucleus is a membrane bound structure. So, it won't be present in the eubacteria. So, you can easily eliminate that. Cell wall, okay, cell wall you can easily eliminate that because most of the eukaryotic cells are absent, cell wall is absent. Even though the cell wall is present, that will be made up of completely different nature of cell wall. In case of plants, the cell wall is made up of cellulose. In case of bacteria, the cell wall is made up of the peptidoglycan. Okay, there won't be any resemblance of cell wall in the both the characters. But the plasma membrane of bacteria is almost similar to the eukaryotes. The correct choice for the question is plasma membrane. And see the next question. The membrane bound organelles are absent in. As I told you, all the eukaryotic cells, they are having the membrane bound structures. The first kingdom, the Monera, they won't have the bacteria, they won't have the membrane bound structures. See the choices: Saccharomyces, Streptococcus, Chlamydomonas and Plasmodium. Okay, and you have to find out the common nature of the choices. Saccharomyces belongs to, the Saccharomyces is the yeast, belongs to fungi. Chlamydomonas, Plasmodium belongs to protists. Okay, they all eukaryotic cell structures, they are having the membrane bound structures, so you can easily eliminate the eukaryotes. Streptococcus is a bacteria, belongs to Monera, they won't have the membrane bound structures. So the choice over here, the membrane bound organelles are absent in Streptococcus. Okay, so this is how you have to read and analyze the question to answer the particular type of question. Now we are going to see the next set of questions. And see the next question now. Archaebacteria differs from eubacteria in, okay, and see the choices. Cell membrane structure, mode of nutrition, mode of reproduction and cell shape. And this question, as I told you, talking about the archaebacteria and comparison in between eubacteria. Okay, so eubacteria and archaebacteria belongs to the Monera kingdom. Okay, and there are some major differences in between these two categories. They are morphologically, they are almost identical to each other. Their mode of reproduction, budding or division or fission, are almost similar. Okay, so mode of reproduction, their nutrition characters are almost similar, but cell shape, as I told you, morphologically they are similar, but their cell membrane and the cell wall structure is completely different. Okay, normally the archaebacteria are called extremophiles. They can survive in extreme conditions, extreme salt environment, extreme temperature, extreme radioactive materials. Okay, so they are called extremophiles. That means their cell membrane and cell wall is being adapted to survive in the particular environment. And the question over here talking about how differs from the normal bacteria, they are differs from the normal bacteria by their cell membrane or cell wall nature. Okay, and see the next question. The cyanobacteria also referred to us. Okay, so normally in the earlier days the taxonomists were confused with the placing of the particular cyanobacteria, because this is a kind of bacteria, they can do the particular photosynthesis. Okay, so they are confused with the placement of the particular group into Monera or the particular protista Euglena. They can perform the particular the photosynthetic. Okay, so there are choices given for you: protist, golden algae, slime mold and blue green algae. As I told you, it is belongs to a bacteria, that is Monera. All the remaining choices, protista, algae, slime molds, belongs to eukaryotic cells. So the choice over here is blue green algae or BGA. Okay, so the cyanobacteria also refer to as blue green algae. See the next question. Lichens are well known combination of an algae and a fungus. Okay, so where, what may be the role of fungi, where a fungus has a role. Okay, so as I told you, as we have seen in the introduction classes, lichens is a combination of a fungus and a algae. And what may be the role of fungi? As I told you, this relationship is called symbiosis. Okay, that means both the partners gonna get benefit from each other. Okay, this is what you have to remember. And see the choices: saprophytic, epiphytic, parasitic and symbiotic. Okay, as I told you, you can easily eliminate the parasitic, epiphytic and saprophytic. This relationship is a symbiotic association. So symbiotic relationship with the algae. See the final question over here. The vector for sleeping sickness is, okay, sleeping sickness is a disease caused by the parasite Trypanosoma. Okay, and this will be carried by the, this parasite is being carried by the vector. That vector is tsetse fly. Okay, tsetse fly, you can easily eliminate the remaining choices. And this is how you have to identify and answer the particular type of question. As I told you, today we have seen something about the questions we can expect from the first two chapters of the particular unit. Living, we have seen questions from the living world apart from the second chapter, the biological classification. In the biological classification, we have seen questions from the first major three kingdoms, the Monera, Protista and Fungi. What may be the question, or what kind of questions we can expect from the particular type of the kingdom. As I told you over here, you have to identify the kingdom and you should know the characters. The major characters belongs to the particular kingdom, and you should know some major examples belong to the particular kingdom. Based on that, you have to identify the question and you have to analyze and answer the questions. Okay. So what are the things you have to study for the particular unit? What are the kingdoms and what are the major characters? And what may be the identification characters for the particular kingdom, and what are the major common examples for the particular kingdom. In the same way, we are going to continue with the next kingdoms, the animal kingdom and the plant kingdom in the next sessions. Okay. So then we are going to discuss the questions from the particular chapter.